Hey guys, welcome back to some more Pokemon adventures. I'm Mark, this is Sam. Say hello, Sam.
Hello, Sam.
Yes, we have been travelling the UK, finding places that have inspired the brilliant games Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield. And today we're off to...
Manchester.
That's right, Manchester.
Manchester is one of the most iconic and well-known cities in the UK. And it was an inspiration for the town Motostoke, an amazing industrial city found in Gala. It's one of the main cities in Pokémon Sword and Shield.
So, let's pick up today's guest who can show us around Motostoke.
Wow!
Sally,
look at this, guys. Welcome to Manchester. This bus is incredible.
Hey, fancy hopping aboard?
I'd love to.
Come on.
It is so lovely to have you here.
Thank you so much for having me. I heard you guys are aspiring Pokemon trainers.
We are indeed aspiring.
We're trying our best.
Yeah, the adventure's going well so far?
Yeah, it's not going too bad at all. We're loving it, put it that way.
Yeah.
Well, this bus is absolutely fantastic, and I'm going to give you a little bit of a tour of one of the Pokemon Sword and Shield towns called Motostoke, which is inspired by where we are right now, Manchester. Welcome. So yeah, this is Motostoke. Take a look and wait a little bit here. We may see, there we go.
Nice.
A little bit of a tram going by, and take a look at the upper level of Motostoke here. We can see actually a giant gym area as well. We can actually go ahead, progress a little bit more in the game, take on one of the gym leaders, but we're not quite gonna do that yet. And there's so many different parts and secrets, it's amazing. Yeah. And you can see all of the people here. Oh, look, Pokemon playing hopscotch or something there as well, yeah. We're gonna end up where we started off, believe it or not. So if we come up here, this is actually where we started our tour back in the shopping district.
Yes, of course it is.
So we're going to head over to the right, which is where we can go ahead and customise our hair, eyes, makeup even, however we want to spend our money.
This is what I want.
Yeah, this is it.
I need a haircut.
Why don't we go ahead and first do a haircut? Okay. The great thing is, obviously it's an avatar, you can make it like yourself, or you can just go wild.
Oh, okay, nice.
So we can do whatever we want to. There's loads of customisation here. So we can keep on going through. So look, all the hair. Yeah.
I think I should be in charge.
Yeah, that's a good point, Mark.
I don't want you in charge of my hair.
Do not put me in charge of his hair.
Right.
Should we have a look at the Caesar cup?
Yeah, we got a...
crispy hairline there.
Side part.
Nice.
That's quite similar to mine.
Undercut.
Fashionable. That's cool.
Bowl cut. Hello.
That's when you really need to go. Back in the day, that
Which
was.
One are we thinking?
I think medium and wavy.
Yeah, that's quite similar to mine at the minute.
Yeah,
I like definitely. That hair.
Right, you can change the colour. Okay. Do you want gold hair, Sam? Shiny.
Like a surfer. Like
pink. Ash brown sounds nice. Oh no, maybe not.
No.
Right. So let's take a look. We're in a little bit more customization. So go down and click different options. We've got colors, we've got black eyes.
Shall we go for multicolor swirl?
Yep.
Yes, please. That's good.
One of my favorites, click burning passion. look at that fiery eyes.
I think the ultramarine.
Yay, I can't lie.
Brilliant.
That is some they blue
are
nice. Eyes.
Oh, good, aren't they?
Piercing eyes.
To complete the package, we need to have amazing clothes as well. Look as fashionable as possible.
Yeah, well, obviously.
Yeah, just up to the top there, this is where all of the most fashionable clothes in the whole of Motostoke can be found. So I've actually gone ahead, guys, and already picked out some nice pieces for you. Some nice items of clothing. I'm your personal shopper.
Trust you, because, I mean, look at this bad boy
that you're wearing. Snorlax Original Stitch by Pokemon. Absolutely love it, can't lie.
Pretty good.
See an odd Pikachu in there as well.
Nice,
so, love it.
That's brilliant.
Awesome.
Let's see what we've got.
Yeah, so let's take a look. Head on into the back, head on into the changing room. Here you'll see all of the items you've already purchased, so I've got a few to take a look.
Yeah, hello!
Transform Sam.
I love it. I look good.
You've never looked better.
Remember the old Pokemon Center?
Yes.
We're going to go and have a look now. The Pokemon Center is a staple point of any big town or city that you're visiting on your Pokemon journey. As I said, you can heal your Pokemon here. You can switch your Pokemon in and out of boxes. You can even buy items. And we're actually going to go ahead and update our league card. This is like your personalized, as I said, card almost.
Okay.
That you will use to share with other trainers around the world and represent yourself.
Oh, wow.
So, take a look at backgrounds first.
Yeah.
We've got some interesting designs.
Oh, nice. It's quite tartan, isn't it? Quite Scottish.
And this is where we get to model your newly customized, very fashionable in-game character.
Okay. Okay.
We can move it, we can change the expression, and we can also change the pose. Really, you should be loving life right
now.
That's true. You're about to show off to the world how excited you are to be in Motostoke, create your own league card. Look at all of these expressions.
I love it. Well, I like this one.
Hey! Hey!
Yeah, but you're missing my lovely eyes.
I know,
there.
You want to see, you want to see eyes. What about that? Ooh.
Oh, she's a bit shocked.
Okay. Looks like about to fight someone.
The new one, the one, second one in.
Yay! Yay!
It's got to be that one, hasn't it? Yeah.
Come on, I like that.
You can actually change the pose.
Oh, whoa! Yes!
Now you're talking.
Yeah.
Ha. There we go.
Ta.
Oh, that's strong.
Yeah,
confident.
Yeah. Ooh.
Better go into song.
Yeah, that's a good
point. I like arms folded.
I think for this.
That is a power pose. All right, if you're happy with that, click A. Print it, baby.
Print it.
Yes.
Ooh.
Wow. Hours and hours and hours of fun just doing that. So
now, as much fun as it is, we don't have any more time to do that. You're already looking beautiful now. You've got your league card. We need to move on to some max raid battles.
Oh.
Yes, we're going to be heading to a den, taking on a Dynamax Pokemon. Are you guys ready?
I'm so ready.
Okay, I'm ready.
Come on.
All right, we're going to do some raiding. So, here we are, back in the wild area. I believe you did a little bit of exploration here with Claire, actually.
We did, yeah. We made a curry.
Ooh,
which
nice.
Was lovely.
Now, here in the wild area, Claire may have briefly mentioned it, but we're going to explore it in full today. You see that red beam of light? Make your way over there. Okay. Maybe avoid the grassy area. We're not going to battle any of the wild Pokemon for the moment. We are going to be going ahead and actually going into a den. You can see these dens here sometimes having a red beam of light coming out of them, and that actually signifies that there is a max raid battle going on. Let me explain something. So there's a phenomenon in the Galar region where Pokemon can actually go ahead and Dynamax. This makes them absolutely huge, massive versions of themselves.
Okay.
And we can actually take some of these on in these max raid battles.
It wasn't.
You know what? I'm actually here to help you. I'm not going to guide you through this, but I've actually come along prepared, and I too will be battling with you.
Yo!
You can do that!
Oh, yes!
That is so cool!
Come on!
Take a look! This is your very first Dynamax. These are the people we're battling with!
Look at the size of that!
Bunnelby, absolutely huge. Obviously, because it's Dynamax, it is a lot bigger than our poor little Pokemon. However, thanks to the Dynamax band that you guys have been given by the professor, you can actually go ahead and Dynamax as well. So if you just, and we're going to go ahead and click the Dynamax button.
Nice.
And Max Knuckle is super effective against this Bunnelby.
Okay.
It's got to be that, hasn't it?
I was dragging
that. Yeah.
Max Knuckle it is.
So let's go and start the battle, and look at this.
Come on.
Ooh, so your Reboot is about to go ahead and Dynamax and be just as big.
Oh, cool.
Yeah,
it's
absolutely big. Wow.
Yes, Reboot.
Let's go. Absolutely huge. This is super effective. Max Knuckle. Huge damage. And it's attacking back. Luckily, it didn't attack either of us.
Nice.
Attacked one of the computers, so we're okay.
Thanks, computer.
And it's roly-coly!
Oh!
It's a critical hit!
Critical hit! My roly-coly coming in doing loads
of
damage.
Nice work.
We've got the opportunity to catch this Dynamax Pokemon. We're going to cross all of our fingers.
Okay, yeah. Come on.
And hope that we can catch it. Pokeball's massive, Pokemon's massive, can we catch it?
Turn to green.
One.
Two.
That's good. Three. Just needs to click, needs to close.
Yes!
Woo!
Excellent.
Go. So, how did you enjoy your very first Dynamax battle?
Oh, so awesome. Especially because we won.
Yeah, exactly.
Winning is always great. Dynamax battles are great, but you can even go bigger and better. You can actually do Gigantamax battles as well. Now, I won't be sharing that with you guys quite yet. Something to think about, though, for the future.
Yeah, isn't that what we saw in the first episode?
Of course.
That's right, yes. Massive Charizard.
That was the one.
So just a little bit of a teaser for something else you guys will be taking a look at. But for now, I hope you enjoyed your very first Dynamax battle.
It was awesome, man.
Thanks for your help as well. We definitely needed it.
The search for Pikachu continues.
According to the Pokédex, Pikachu belong to the category of mouse.
Oh, mouse, eh? Oh.
It also says here that male and female Pikachu can be identified by the shape of their tail. Oh. See, a female Pikachu tail is the shape of the upper half of a heart.
Oh, that's cute, isn't it? I really hope we catch a Pikachu before this adventure ends.
Tell me about it, Mark.
Mystery gift! Hey! We'll open that with Ali-A later.
Good idea. In fact, should we just get back to the bus?
Yeah.
I'm not sure there's any Pikachu around here anyway.
Excited for this?
Yeah, we love this bit. We love this bit.
I cannot wait. Let's kick it off. As you know, within the video game, we're talking about Gigantamax Pokemon and a little bit of a teaser as to what it is.
Yeah.
We're going to be starting off here within the trading card game with Lapras V, nice, which can actually Gigantamax into... Oh, Lapras VMAX. So if you take a look at the card, not only is it beautifully shiny,
nice,
but it also has a different form. So it looks even cooler as well.
Yeah,
so has, good.
Yeah, it looks amazing.
Yeah.
So let's just break it down a little bit more. And we're going to take a look at this very cute Yampa.
Nice.
So there's some information on here. It is a basic Pokemon, which I think you guys have talked about.
Yes, because obviously some Pokemon can evolve, just like Scorbunny did.
Yes, Reboot.
Reboot, exactly.
Reboot, yeah.
And in the top right-hand corner, you can see HP.
Yeah.
So this is the amount of hit points the Pokemon card has. If this gets knocked down to zero, the Pokemon will be knocked out. We want to avoid that for our own cards.
Yeah.
So on the bottom here, to actually deal damage to the opposition's hit points, we've got our own attacks. So for example, if we take a look here, we can do Static Shock for 10 damage. But in the case of needing to do these attacks, you're going to need energy cards.
Yeah.
So for example, Static Shock's going to need one electric energy.
Right.
You're going to need to have pulled an electric energy. So you can attach this to the Yampa. And you're now in a position where you can go ahead and do the Static Shock damage.
Brilliant.
So could you not use that move unless you had that other card?
Yes, exactly.
Right. Okay.
Oh,
so you need to have your energy cards so useful
in the
trading card game.
Okay.
Nice.
And so guys, next up, I'm going to let you guys know the traditional layout for playing the Pokemon card game. Starting off, you've got your active Pokemon. This will be the Pokemon that is ready to attack the opposition. And you can see that they've got their own active Pokemon that will take the attacks and vice versa as well.
Okay.
So that's your active Pokemon. You can also have bench Pokemon as well. This can be an additional 5 other Pokemon. Mm. And these are like ready, waiting in the sidelines to potentially be moved into the active spot. In total, you can max out at 6 Pokemon, which is obviously the same as the video game as well.
Yeah.
Your party can contain 6 Pokemon in total. Now, if your Pokemon gets knocked out or if you use a trainer card, it then goes into the discard pile here in the corner. And each turn you'll draw cards from your own deck that you've put together, a deck that you've created to try and take down anyone else that you're battling. And this will be placed in the deck pile. Super simple. Now, to win a game, you need to try and take all of your prize cards. There are 6 in total, and you'll pull a prize card for each opposition's Pokemon you take down. So you want to go ahead, you want to take down the opposition's Pokemon cards, draw the prize cards until you've taken them all and won.
Nice.
Brilliant. Well, that seems pretty straightforward and simple.
Can we open the mystery gift now?
Oh, okay.
Ooh, come on then. This
mystery
is exciting.
Gift.
Yeah, we found this earlier when we were trying to look for Pikachu.
Yeah,
nice.
We didn't want to open it until we were with you.
I appreciate that. Thank you, guys.
Yeah, here we go.
Yes, more boost packs.
Oh,
yes.
My gosh. This is what I've been waiting for.
Okay.
Are we going to get into it?
Oh, sorry. I was being so rude. I'm so sorry. Don't open it yet.
Can't lie.
Go on.
May have come prepared with just a few of my own.
Right,
I'm ready.
Should we get in there?
Yeah, who wants to go first? You guys open one first.
Okay.
Go on, Sam.
Well, maybe I should go first because I don't know if you remember in the last episode.
Yeah.
I pulled out a really rare card. I don't know if Claire mentioned it to
you. I may have heard this story already.
He told everyone, that's why.
I called my mum straight after this. a gold Zamazenta, which apparently is very, very rare.
I am jealous.
Yeah?
My goal to pull a better card.
Oh, okay.
It's not going to be easy.
Okay, so we've got the energy card like we just talked about.
Yeah, super important.
We do need that.
Psychic energy. Ooh, Hitmonlee.
Yeah.
Nice, he's all about those kicks. Rare candy, useful.
Nice. Yeah.
Ooh, a Scroopy.
Scroopy.
Nice, I like this one. Ooh, Wooloo. Fan favorite from the Galar region. Oh,
Sobble.
Nice.
Classic Sobble.
Another nice Pokemon there as well. That is a shiny Cloyster. Not bad.
Oh, should we see if we've got a rare one?
Let's go, this is
it. You excited?
Come on! Snorlax V! Look at that!
I am on fire!
Look at two 120 hit points.
Whoa!
Honestly, I am too good at this.
Stop it.
I'm a bit worried here. I could have tried and matched those cards.
Okay. Good luck with that.
Right, who's next?
I'll go next.
Go on then.
All right, okay. Right.
Okay, let's see what we can get. Kicking off with an electric energy.
Come on.
Quillfish. Nice water type Pokemon. Ooh, a Chincho. Electric Pokemon. Ooh, Croagunt as well. Dark type Pokemon.
Oh,
that is. It's not bad. This is good so far. Good so far. Ooh, this is a Galarian Meowth, which is an alternate form to the normal Meowth only found in the Galar region. So
wow.
Very cool.
Wow, nice.
Yeah, love that.
That's good.
Ooh, Scorbunny.
Let's go.
It's a holographic wound.
Oh, yeah.
Looking good.
There
and that means the next one is. Ooh.
Oh!
Are you kidding me? Another V Pokemon. This is Stonjourner. This one is huge.
Really?
Yes.
Bigger than Snorlax V?
If we take a look at the weakness on Snorlax V, we can see it is fighting type, which means it will take double damage from a fighting type move. And as we take a look here, Stonjourner is a fighting type.
Oh,
which means in a battle, you never know who's going to win, but advantage is towards Stonjourner, I'm afraid. Right, time to open my pack.
Okay.
Let's take a look. Starting off with fighting type energy.
Lovely.
And then a hyper potion. They've got a citrus berry.
Nice.
Oh, we've got Core Squire as well.
Oh, it looks a bit like Rookie D.
Oh, it does, yeah.
Ooh, one of your favorite Pokemon. Yeah, this will evolve from that, which is awesome.
That makes
Krabby.
Sense.
And we've also got Mincino as well. Moving on. Oh, yes, another Galarian Pokemon. This is Galarian Form Ponyta. And then we've got ourselves another Scorbunny. Okay, we've got some big ones coming up, hopefully. Holographic Poke Kid Trainer card.
Nice.
What is behind it? My best card of the pack.
Oh!
Dreadnought! This guy is awesome.
Yeah.
He's also new to the Galar region as well. Nice, nice.
What have we got here?
Oh! You've got a good one, show camera! Oh. Let's have a look,
That does look
a
good.
Tapu Koko!
Oh, we got ourselves another V Pokemon, 200 HP. And that is impressive artwork
in
front.
It's a beautiful card.
Yeah, I think you are winning the card battle right now.
No, never!
Open up more packs.
Yes! What was your rare one that you got earlier?
Oh, gosh.
What was your rare one that you got earlier?
What's he got?
Stonjourner.
Stonjourner. Let me look at Stonjourner.
Okay.
What about Stonjourner VMAX?
Oh, he's gone and done it. 330 HP. He's got the VMAX version.
So what you're saying is I've smashed him.
What I'm saying is that I'm not even contesting in this Pokemon trading
card
game.
What if I put all three of them together and we can
Nah, mate.
Ooh, put that right there. Look at that. He's only gone ahead and pulled a golden metal saucer.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Oh, he's so excited.
It's a VMAX, my first one I've pulled. Bam! Look at
that, ladies and gentlemen. Whoa.
It is a Morpeego VMAX. Woo! That is a Galar region Pokemon as well. Look at the beautiful sparkle. I feel like something good's coming over here. What's going on?
Samazenta V.
No! Look at that! 230 HP, legendary Pokemon from the Galar region.
Feels good, doesn't it?
It really does. It feels great.
I've gone ahead and pulled my favorite Pokemon in the game, a holographic Gengar. And
then if I open up
the next card, Rainbow Rare! Team Yell Grunt, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that. When you see the rainbow colors, you know it is rare.
That is good.
Ooh, I don't know if you're going to be able to top that, guys.
I really don't think they are. Well done.
Super happy. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I've got a gift for you guys. If you take a look down there, you'll see a little box.
Oh, amazing.
Oh, look at this.
That is a beautiful Battle Academy Pokemon TCG. Within there, you'll find several decks and you'll be able to learn the basics yourself and actually play your own games of Pokemon trading card game.
Oh, mate, well, thank you for the gift and thank you for being on the bus with us. We've learned a lot, haven't we?
We really have. Oh, and actually, Ali, I think this might be your stop.
That's right. I think it's time for me to go. Guys, thank you so much.
Pleasure, man. It's been amazing.
Thank you, guys.
Bye.
What a nice bloke.
Lovely man. What another fantastic day on the Pokemon bus.
Absolutely. Now, here's a challenge for you. During this episode, Sobble plushies made an appearance.
But did you spot them? If you did, how many did you spot?
Next time on the Pokemon bus, we will be heading to London.
Woo! That is going to be very, very exciting. We'll catch you then.
Bye! Bye.